Starry night.
An astrophysicist from Wheaton is making history. He just discovered the oldest, most distant star.
He spotted it while using the Hubble telescope in 2019 and even got to name the star. Brian Welch is with us this morning to tell us more. Good morning.
Good morning.
So, I'm assuming there's people looking at this Hubble telescope all the time. How did you happen to stumble upon something that no one else saw?
I think I just happened to be in the right place at the right time. So, I was lucky enough to be given this this particular lensed galaxy to look at as part of my PhD work, and it just happened to be, far more interesting than anybody really expected it to be. So I just kind of got lucky to be the person to stumble onto this one.
And to the average person, I'm assuming everything would look like, spots of white light up there. I'm assuming to the trained eye, what you saw looked different. Can you describe it?
Yeah, so we could tell that the galaxy that this particular star is in was going to be very interesting just based on how long and stretched out that looks. So with gravitational lensing, massive objects sort of bend and distort the light from distant objects, which ends up magnifying them, kind of looking through the bottom of a wine glass.
Oh,
and the longer those things stretch out, the more highly magnified they are. So this was one of the most, one of the longest lens galaxies that we knew. So we knew it was going to be a very interesting thing to look at. And then as I was modeling it, I just kind of kept finding that this one little point that arrow is pointing to was predicted to be at an extremely high magnification, that such that it was only consistent with being an individual star.
PhD student, sounds like he knows what he's talking about. Absolutely, I'm impressed here. So how do you verify that actually is the most distant stars and there's not one, beyond it?
So the way that we check the distance is really based on the color of the object. So since the universe is expanding, more distant objects appear redder. And based on the amount of reddening that we see, we can estimate how far away it is. And based on the reddening that we see in this particular galaxy and with this particular star, we can tell that it's about within the first 900 million years of the universe, which puts it just shy of 13 billion years into the past. So we can tell that it's very far away, and it's the most distant one that's been found yet.
And I think we saw the name of the star. You named it. Pronounce it for me. What's the name of it?
Yeah, I named it Arendelle, which is an old English word that means the morning star. So this is a time period of the universe that we often refer to as cosmic dawn. So I thought that a morning star reference fit pretty well.
So does this mean, are you done with school now? I would assume you have a job lined up somewhere, right? What are you doing now?
Yeah, I actually just defended my PhD on Monday. So I'm now officially no longer a PhD student. And next up, I have a job lined up at the NASA Goddard Space Flight Center, where I'm going to be doing more astronomy with very distant galaxies and, potentially looking for more very distant stars.
Real quick, Brian, is the Hubble telescope still a relevant tool here? I know it's 32 years old. Do you expect it to keep operating for many years to come?
Yeah, absolutely. The Hubble is doing great. We really expect it to keep delivering sort of top-notch science for years to come. So it's for a 30-year-old telescope, it's really doing an incredible job.
All right, well,
it's older than he is.
Right.
well done, Brian. Congratulations, and all the best to you.
Thank you.
And for more information, you can check out NASA.gov. I'm sure they'll tell you all about it. Look, we're from right here in Wheaton, doing
right.
Great things.
Smart people out in Wheaton. That was fun.